children and our children's children, those of us that are dreaming today will have the support that we need to build. And so I hope each one of you are ready. And at this time, we'll call on Mr. Dodu.
Hello, everyone. I want to say good morning, and I want you to respond by good morning. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Thank you. Now, the question I have asked myself since I became the president of this association in March is that, what kind of legacy are we leaving for this young people? And this morning, I want you to join me to start a journey, to leave a legacy for our young people, to be able to thrive, to be able to succeed, and to be able to be leaders in our community. I'm also bringing prosperity to people here in Canada and also in Ghana. You know, when you look at history shows that in the world we had an industrial revolution where they had coal and they changed electricity. Now we are in a digital age. Information travels fast. About 20 years ago, the phone I have over here, this small phone, was not available. We know someone by name, Steve Jobs, he brought this small phone, which is called a smartphone. This smartphone, you can do your banking, you check your weather, you can do trade on the, on the stock exchange, you can do calendaring. This smartphone is more powerful than the computer that sent the man to the moon. That is how far we've come as a society. This morning we are meeting here because we want change. President Obama, he campaigned, he used the word change. The change is you. The change you want to see is that is what I want our community to embark. And I have confidence, I have no doubt in my mind, that when we met April 14, and we had a offsite, the Ghanaian-Canadian Association, we sat down with leaders who are not able to recognize what we are. And the question was, what are we going to do to move our community forward? That was the question. I would like to end my presentation to you with a challenge that please, let us come together. Let's rally our people. We are about 100 or 90,000 strong Ghanaians in Ontario. That is powerful. And if we organize ourselves well, and I know we will, we can give hope to the hopeless. We can uplift the downtrodden. We can alleviate poverty. We can create a new generation of entrepreneurs. And I know you will join us and make that happen. May God bless you. And thank you.
Madam Moderator, thank you for the opportunity. As President of the Ghana-Canadian Association of Ontario, Mr. Apesi Emia Adebiu, Director, Diaspora Relations Office at the Presidency, the Consul General, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, it is my utmost honor and privilege to be part of this epoch-making event. I wish to commend the association for what they have done. It is also for this reason that Mr. Abibu has traversed land and sea, over 8,000 kilometers on short notice to come and join us in heaven this lunch. Our continent is a great land and a land of great people, and our country is a basin in this continent. A continent made up of 1.3 billion people. A continent with great wealth, a continent that has history rich and true, cannot be a we would not continue to accept the fact that the share of trade in Africa remains woefully 3%. It is all about systems, it's all about structures, it's all about leadership. And we have the right leadership at this moment in our country to move on. And for Ghanaians, we have so many citizens living in every part of the world, doing all sorts of things that are making their home countries succeed. And some of these Ghanaians all over the world are some of you. You are found in all sectors of economy in your host country. You are driving change in your host country. In a country such as this, a country of 36 million people, the share of that country's trade is 2.5%, close to the share of trade of a continent of 1.2 billion. And so this is time for us to bring about that change at home. And that change in Ghana as well. Because Ghana is a pacesetter. Now what excites me about what the association has done is the establishment of the Diaspora Engagement Think Tank and the Chamber of Commerce. And we are confident that our principles led by Mr. Apusi Ewa Abedio would guide us in doing just that. I cannot end this words of inspiration by thanking him most sincerely for coming and by thanking him for what he did a couple of weeks ago. The organization of the Diaspora Homecoming Summit after 16 years. We've had discussions with them, but I'll leave it to him to tell us what he has for us. I thank you for your attention.
I'm glad to be in a position where I serve my community in my career, as well as in the Ghanaian community. It's a beautiful thing. You know, I've never seen anything negative in our community. I've only seen problems that need to be solved. And that is the way I want us to think. That is the way I want us to see our community. That our flaws are not just flaws. These are things that are happening every day. But as people with vision, as people with passion, as dreamers, what we have to do is to see our problems as things that need to be solved. And on that note, I would like to call on my mom and mentor, Madam Dean of Esteem, to come and speak with us a little bit.
And call me Mama, but I am indeed Mama. I am 80 years this September. Young people, to be able to get in there, to touch, to feel, to see. So I have something like 16,000 photographs and videos and hundreds of documents and speeches, anything that was not under the rule of confidential, you know, documents. So at the archives at York University, all my stuff are there, and young people are using that material. And what I negotiated with York University was a chair, because as I looked around the country and all the universities around the country, there was no chair that spoke to the issues of African Canadians. And since I'm the university is also prepared, and maybe I should have a conversation with you, Mr. President. The university is prepared to have a lecture series at York University on an annual basis if an organization or an individual were to come up with a substantial amount towards that $1.2 million. So maybe the Diaspora could kind of, again, with me, put that that stake, because my Angelou says, and I keep repeating this, she said you can catch, but you must be ready to throw something back. So this is a throwback into an institution, into an academic setting, and into a place where something will be set in perpetuity. So I thank you. I know this is outside the realm of what your discussion is going to be today. If I'm impolite, I ask you, yeah, I apologize. But I think it was important in this gathering to connect the diaspora issues, the work that's happening in the chair with Dr. Carl James and others, and to ensure that as you partner and as you collaborate, that we are part of that partnership and collaboration, because we can move this country forward in a way that will benefit ourselves, our children, and those who follow us as African Canadians. Next week.
It gives me a great pleasure to be here this morning to speak to you about a few thoughts of my heart. Thank you for your welcome. It gives me great pleasure to be able to be part of this. I used to be in Her Majesty's Customs Excise in the UK as an officer dealing with imports and exports. I became a consultant in international trade and in customs and VAT. And it gave me a huge amount of experience in the process of international trade, to the point of teaching it at university and also with the British Chambers of Commerce, of whom I am an accredited member and a trainer and advisor. Why are we all here? We are here because we all have something to contribute to this Chamber of Commerce. We all have talents. We all have specialist skills. But we also have that common desire to trade between Ghana and Canada. In the UK, our government has a slogan which it brought in the past few years: exporting is great. I am committed to exporting. I am committed to importing. I am committed to international trade. And I am committed to fostering trade relations between countries. John F. Kennedy said, "Do not ask what your country can do for you, but ask what you can do for your country. But also ask, what can you do for your community? How can you contribute? It is not for us to gain ourselves. It is for us to contribute." And that's why I thank you for giving me the opportunity to speak to you, to encourage you, to be part of this trading community, to help you, but so that we can all help each other. Ladies and gentlemen, may the Lord bless you all. Thank you very much. Merci beaucoup.
The President is excited about what is happening here, and he sends his warmest regards to you all. When the invitation came down to come to this occasion, we did not hesitate to say yes, this is very much in line with what we are also trying to do as a government. So in that respect, we prepared ourselves to come, even though yes, everything has been left rather late, but the President gives you all his approval for what you're doing. I think I must first begin by saying to the distinguished guest, the chairperson, my dear lady, honorable, Justine, for the inspirational speech he gave, and for the chairperson's inspirational speech, and everything that has been said here today, to the British Chamber of Commerce person. We are here, we are sure we're going to guide this young baby to also be as good as what the things between Britain and Ghana. I think when it comes to Canada, and of course to your distinguished members here, all of you assembled here, I say a big thank you for coming today to grace the occasion. I think when it comes to Canada, I must begin by saying, yes, I have some links with Canada that is worth mentioning. My mom migrated to Canada in the 80s, and she used to live somewhere in Manitoba. I understand it's very cold out there in Manitoba. Needless to say, I never wanted to visit. But then, she was not there just by herself. She was there with my senior brother, who later on also moved to Toronto and also became the Deputy High Commissioner for Ghana in order. And that was his need. We are going through a process of organization to see how best we can be represented in the various countries, to see how best we can engage the Ghanaians. We know already through institutions like yours, like the Chamber of Commerce, we are making a lot of people there. But also through the churches and also through the various home associations, the town associations, the Kruyeko and all that, we are going to reach out as much as possible to tap into what is out there to help with the realization of the dream. Yeah. So I would like this day would like to say yes, we are very much behind your initiative and I hope all goes well. I'm here taking notes to see how, you know, what needs to be added when we go back home. And thank you all for having the time.
So that is what a team did. Without any funding, without any support, we got together day after day, networking, care conferences, everything that it takes to put our links and our structure together so that we can share with you. So this is what we have put together so far, but this is not the end. Because we want you to join us. Are you ready to join us? And we have some surprises for you. I am so glad that Mr. Abigail is taking notes because he mentioned a few things, sensors and equipment getting together, and we have a plan. And we have a plan that's exciting, that is going to bring all of us together, all the skills in the pool. And I'm going to talk about that later. So now, who are we? So what we came up with is that we are a voluntary, non-profit organization. This is about a Chamber of Commerce. Dr. Walker is going to talk about the DETT. We are a voluntary non-profit organization which is affiliated with the GCAO, Ghanaian-Canadian Association of Ontario, and we are based in Toronto. We will promote business, trade, tourism, investment, opportunities between Canada and Ghana. We will also promote business networking, advocacy, partnership, and education between Canada and Ghana. Doesn't that sound good? So now, what is our mission? Our mission is to assemble and to create a platform of professionals and business entrepreneurs. So what we're doing is that it's sort of twofold. We're trying to get all the professionals on board and then trying to get all the business people as well. Because we're talking about the Chamber of Commerce, okay? So our mission is to assemble and create a platform for professionals and business entrepreneurs in the Canadian community, in the Ghanaian community, in Canada, in order for us to engage and address business and other public issues that result in opportunities for success. And also, to play an integral role in the economic development of both Ghana and Canada. So whatever we're doing here, we feel like if we want to invest our skills, knowledge, expertise, everything, we need to build. We need to have a solid foundation, structures in place, connecting and networking with each other. before we can actually help. Or through that process, we will still be helping. So what is our vision? Our vision is to build capacity, stimulate interest, and create opportunities for Ghanaian Canadians, and also to foster trade and investment between Canada and Ghana.
Thank you very much, sir. So at this point, we'd like to stress more on the benefits. So as you enter the room, we've been talking about the Ghanaian-Canadian Chamber of Commerce. By this time, I believe you know who we are, what we are about. But as I look around the hall, I see a lot of investors around. I see people who are very excited and they're asking, why should I get in? What does it mean for me? We've talked a lot about what we can do for our country. We then have to look at what, by joining this organization, what do we gain as business people in general. And so I'm here to talk about that. One of the first areas that we agreed on in a couple of our meetings is that once you join the Ghanaian-Canadian Chamber of Commerce, one of the utmost benefits for you as a business is that you'll be able to connect between Canada and Ghana. We have the expertise in identifying which areas of business you've been trying to invest in. We are the think tank that can give us serve as a research for you to be able to gain those benefits. Another area that makes us very unique, I know Robotan was here talking about the British Chamber of Commerce, but one of the unique ways in our Chamber of Commerce, in doing this in our Chamber of Commerce, is that we have a think tank behind us, which means that if you're a member, you then gain sort of insights from the Chamber of Commerce. The Chamber of Commerce will do research for you. For instance, if you're trying to go into business of agriculture, we can then reach out to our folks, and then you'll be able to give us some insights. You also have access to our membership directory, which there is a solid website where individuals can go on to research about your business, thereby promoting your business to the world in general. You also have access to a variety of discounts and some of our printing, such as our newsletters, getting free newsletters. You also have access to training. Now, one of the most important benefits that I feel I need to stress on is that the GCC will provide mentorship to the youth as well. And for that matter, the youth here will gain entrepreneurial skills and will learn from the best. We have a lot of doctors, lawyers, plumbers within our groups. And so when we find a young man trying to find a way on how to move forward in life, he can rely on us. For businesses as well, one of the best things that we can do for businesses is networking, which we are doing this afternoon. Networking, as a business person, you know, is very essential. And so by joining the GCC, you gain that benefit. We don't like to talk that much because we're putting the benefits in the brochure. Thank you very much for coming. I wish you all the best. Thank you. God bless you.
Thank you. Currently the chair of Georgia and Health University. I'm going to team up with Dr. Victor Awafo. Just give you some general overview, and this Victor will give you the PowerPoint presentation.
Yes.
I'll be very quick. It has been a while since we've been in Canada. If you remember way back when the Ghanaian diaspora community started settling here, the argument was the idea that we are draining the country of mental power, not only intellectuals, but all the technical power is coming out of the country. Of course, then the idea was that Canada was gaining and Ghana's brain was being drained. Now, we got to a situation where what we find is that there are so many who are here with some qualifications that you cannot even find something. So the literature now has been somehow contextualized as though there is some brainwaves going on. But of course, we can, from brain drain to brain gain to brain waste, what is being realized now is that indeed it is not being wasted at all. You find a situation where most of us are constantly going back and forth. So the literature is now moving from brain gain, brain drain, brain waste to brain circulation. And this is what all this is about. So that they are supplementing the ideas. It could be a plumbing job, it could be an electrician, it could be a teaching position. But what we do here, we transfer it back to Ghana. You can see when we go back home now, the building technology is improving. Most of it started with the diaspora community and our ideas of how to do windows, how to do tiles, and all those things. So we are separating the ideas back. But so far, what we seem to lack compared to the advanced countries, of course, we can talk so many things as to why African countries are behind. But if you look at it clearly, you see that the emphasis on research is lacking. We don't do a lot of research. So the idea of a think tank is very, very, very crucial.
Just so that we get this thing going, we heard this morning from Mr. Abio about advocacy in Ghana, how the diaspora office in Ghana can play that role. That is exactly what the DETT in Canada is all about. It's going to be an advocacy platform for the Ghanaian community. And for us to be able to do that, we have to have strategies in place. We have to establish something like the experts. That's where the skill bank comes in. So what we are planning to do directly after this, as you heard from Alaidu, is to invite all of you here with the form that you have on the table. Tell us what your specialty is in, tell us how we can contact you, and then by invitation from the community, we'll start looking at some of the areas that we can start think tank and provide solutions to our community.
Are you in the tank?
Yes.
Are you open to do when we see you on the I'm Eric Yano, I'm the Vice President of the Ghanaian-Canadian Association of Ontario, one of the youth. And the speed that you mentioned is a speed by one of my icons, Barack Obama. Change will not come if we decide to wait for another person, because we are the change and the people will be waiting for. Let's make the change now and this effect. I have with me here the youth, with the youth coordinator, which is a person of Mr. Amani. We have the assistant coordinator, Mr. Richard. We have our secretary of the Canadian Association, who is also a youth, Brother Gabriel. We have our lady human affairs, Sister Lipien, is a youth. We have all of them, if I decide to mention the names, I think the time will take it by storm. Let's all get involved, especially our creative. Those who know me, I'm a Master of Divinity student, but I believe that if we, the Christian, we decide to stay back, if we decide not to fight him and lead people to a time will come and say they are living the Christians out. Let's come on board. Go to your church, invite them. Go to your church, bring them. Let's all come and fight a good fight with all our strength, for Christ is our strength and joy for Ghana and Canada.
May every group here, we are in the tent. We hope that you join us in that tent. Because we need your knowledge, we need your advice, we need all the little things that you know about this world that we need. Because as you can see, we are all so young. We need that bridge, we need that gap, we need to bring that gap so that we get to the level that you guys are in right now. So please join us in the tent. We have young businessmen, we have young entrepreneurs here that we want to reach the cities that you guys are in right now. And my name is Richard Schmessy. Me, my group, the youth here, and my assistants and my colleagues, we all want to reach the city that you guys are in. Help us in the tent. So please join us in the tent. Are you in the tent?
Yeah! And what's the tent? We have our parents tell us we gotta be lawyers, we gotta be doctors, we gotta be, you know, we gotta sit in the office. We're gonna start mentorship programs in which we help our youth become tradesmen. They can be plumbers, they can become mechanics. I guess there's a lot of youth that are around, and they're like, oh, daddy's telling me we gotta be a lawyer, we gotta be this, we gotta be that, but we can't do it. Not that you can't do it. Well, probably you can, probably that's not your interest, but at least let's get behind our youth to follow their dreams so that they can be good ambassadors of the Ghanaian community in Toronto. So are you in the tank? Are you in the tank?
Yeah.
My name is Gimbo Darkin, the Executive Secretary from the Ghanaian Association. We're really excited to be here today because it's about time that we bridge the gap between first generation and second generation professionals and entrepreneurs. So the idea of the Chamber of Commerce is something that we're really, really excited about. As an entrepreneur and philanthropist myself, the idea of a directory where it gives us visibility and also access to a wide range of clients is something that we really, really appreciate. So in conclusion, we the young adults here are excited about this idea of a sustainable professional and business networking platform. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. You're our hope, you're our future, all the best, and keep working hard. Don't give up. In fact, I think you should wear as Vivian is supposed to say something. Hi everyone.
Hello.
Good morning, good afternoon. My name is Vivian O'Forey. I am a member of the GCAO Youth Sector and also part of the Women's Affair. I'm also the director for Our Willingness is Now Ghana Initiative, which we go by own. And just like Kelly was saying, we do the same line of job, giving back home, taking advantage of the opportunities we have here and trying to make a difference back home. Just something that we've been working hard and so passionate about. I'm extremely proud and humbled to be part of this journey because it's something when you see other communities put together something that's gonna set the future bright for the young ones. We mentor kids after school every Sunday and we see just the passion that is in the kids. Just to see that their parents are actually putting forward something. Kelly talked about her uncle going up to the actual to the space. And I said, whoa, I wish I had an uncle. Like I said, if I had an uncle going up to the space, I'm thinking this is so simple. But that's what we're here for. This opportunity that Mr. Dodu, Mama Adu, everybody has been able to set. In the future, one of the kids can say, you know, my parents or my aunties or my uncles were part of the Chambers of Commerce or the fintech. I'm so excited I start to bumble. I'm in the tech, so they'll be so proud and so passionate to want to be with something within the community. So thank you all for coming. Thank you all for pushing, and it's amazing to see the numbers and just everybody doing such a great job in the community. So thank you so much.
Ladies and gentlemen, are we proud of our children? Are we going to stand behind them? Are we going to encourage their dreams? Are we not going to be Mr. and Mrs. Legacy?
No.
We will be Mr. and Mrs.
Legacy.
So if your child says, I want to be a plumber, let me tell you, some plumbers make more money than the doctor.
Yeah.
The lawyer. So let's